My name is Altair Kaminsky. I'm the manager of PLM and digital strategy, and I work for Northrop Grumman. The sector I work in is the space sector, and I report up through the propulsion systems division. And propulsion systems is focused on developing solid rocket motors. We're seeing that there's a lot of product complexity. We have a lot of drivers where we're trying to reuse existing products, but make it turn into a system of systems. We're having expectations from our customers that we need to be able to deliver new products faster or updates to existing products faster. We have drivers around lifecycle obsolescence and how to support that end of the spectrum. And we also have needs around change management, understanding not only why we're making the change, but what impacts a change has across the entire array of the product. Digital transformation is a journey. It's a journey that right now we don't think has necessarily an endpoint, but it's something that we're progressing towards. We know we need to focus on business and operations so we can drive efficiencies into all of our business processes to help us move faster. And then we know we need to help support our programs and make sure that we're providing the right tools to support that digital transformation. We're using Siemens products to support our product lifecycle management, as well as some of the CAD management and even down into some of the manufacturing applications. Technology enablers are anything that helps us connect our data. The data is key to gaining the information, but connecting it is where the real power of digital transformation comes from. That's when you have opportunities to see bigger pictures and pull out information that you couldn't necessarily see if the data was siloed. For the launch abort system manifold, we were able to see a 25% weight reduction by being able to have access to both the model and being able to run a bunch of iterations on the design in order to get that optimal efficiency as far as the weight was concerned. It's okay to start the digital journey in the middle or even closer to the end. You don't have to start that journey at the very beginning to gain some of the benefits of digital transformation. I see PLM as a massive hub for storing and managing a lot of the information that's going to be required to get this concept of a digital thread. It helps us tie the relationships together, and it helps us bring in additional information. The PLM tools have to be able to connect to external systems, and then that is going to be key to making sure that you can maintain that digital thread and follow it all the way through the life cycle process. We do have users who heavily rely on the PLM system for their absolute daily work. They live in that system. So it's really important to making sure that we understand how to maintain the data and make sure that it's well managed. Digital twin is that you have a virtual representation of an actual physical product. And the power in that, the example that I gave was a jet that we were able to use and put test nose cones on with radar software and fly that plane around and test the software real time, getting feedback directly from that nose cone that was on that plane flying around. And we were able to make some really good analysis on how the software was working and if it needed to be adjusted or not. I am a huge proponent of giving people autonomy and empowering them. It's the people who are the closest to the problem who are going to be able to help solve it. We need to make sure that the entire company has this concept of digital transformation. And if they can embrace that change, that's how we get to the end goal of being a digital company.